When you're a student, you're at that point where you don't have enough money to buy a high-end computer. But again, you also don't need one because you're just going to use Microsoft Word and Excel. But when you're a design student, not only don't you have enough money, but you can't use any computer. You need a computer that meets all of your requirements. So let's take a look at a guide to choosing your computer for architecture school or for just entry-level architects. And I want to mention that I won't be promoting any specific brands or computers right here. This is just a guide on what requirements you maybe need to check on over when you're going to buy your computer. Also, this video is considering you're an entry-level architect, meaning you do a little bit of everything, maybe rendering, 3D modeling, etc. But if you are in a specialized field, like for example, ArcViz, then this video maybe isn't for you. And I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. The first 1,000 people to click the link in the description will get 30% off a premium annual membership so you can explore your creativity. And of course, I also want to thank my Patreons for supporting this channel. If you want to join the list of these creative, awesome people, then click the link in the description. So you walk into the store and you see a wide range of options, from the super cheap computers that mostly only work for opening a Word document to the Mac Beauty you've always wanted and would love to get, but it costs almost the same as your school tuition. This can be confusing. Where do you actually start looking? I recommend you keep these few elements in mind. Maybe write them down on your cell phone or on a piece of paper. And that is hard drive, CPU, RAM, graphics card, and screen size. Those five things are the most important things that you will need to know when buying your computer. So you're trying to decide between a PC and a Mac. Well, I am a very biased person because I have been with PC almost all of my life, but I do envy the whole Mac ecosystem. I do envy the true colors that a Mac screen can only give. And I also envy like the whole hardware design and the whole sleekness of Macs. But if I really had to choose, I would choose PC every time. PCs are just compatible with all the programs that maybe we would need. You can also get a very good PC for a good price instead of a Mac that has to compromise a lot of things. So if you want to go for the safe route, I recommend you go PC all the way. But if you're more into design, into how you will look working on your computer, then I guess you can choose a Mac. Okay, so let's talk about CPUs. A CPU is the electronic circuitry within a computer that carries out the instructions of a computer program by performing the basic arithmetic, logic, controlling, and input-output operations specified by the instructions. The CPU plays a very important role in telling the graphics card what to show on your screen, and it will be working hard while you are editing your work on any program. The more details and objects you have in your 3D models, for example, the more instructions your CPU needs to send to your graphics card. So here are two processors that you can choose according to your budget. If we go on the minimum requirements that you can use, I would recommend using an Intel Core i7 of 7th generation or an Intel Core i5 of 9th generation. And this is being super minimum. This is taking into account that you're going to use your computer for around maybe 2 years, and after that you maybe want to upgrade. But a recommended processor that can last you maybe a little bit more would be an Intel Core i7 of 9th generation or an AMD Ryzen 3700X. And if you're trying to decide between AMD processors or Intel processors, I would really recommend the whole AMD world just because they're one of the most recommended among the gaming community, and that is what is closest to what we're going to do in real life as architects. So with all of these parameters, you always want to go for the highest number. So if you can get a higher number in processor, then that will always be much, much better. Of course, you may go a little bit over the budget, but just take into account that this computer could last you maybe your whole university years instead of buying two or three computers that only last you for a year or 2 years. Now let's talk about graphics card. A graphics card is a device installed in a computer that consists of a graphics processing unit designed to help process and display images, especially 3D graphics. Graphics card can help take the processing strain off the main processor and can contain their own memory to take the strain off the system RAM. So you're going to want a good graphics card because this is going to determine your capability of working in 3D space in a very fluid way. In this space, I always like to guide myself by the Lumion standards. Lumion has certain technical requirements for their program each year because, you know, each upgrade comes with new trees, features, materials, etc. So it also requires more specs on your computer. So I recommend you always visit Lumion's page to determine which graphics card they recommend will give optimum performance. Graphic cards have a sort of a public rating where you can see where one stands in comparison to the rest. They call it the Passmark list. And you can also visit their page. They have benchmarks of graphic cards, CPUs, hard drives, etc. But if you are looking for a minimum cheap option, then I recommend you go for the GeForce RTX 1650 or the AMD Radeon RX 470. If you have a little bit more budget and want to go to the higher end, then I suggest you get an RTX 3080 or higher. Also remember that graphic cards have a memory as well, so you want to get a very high memory in this one. With my current setup, I currently have 8 GB of memory, but if you can go higher than that, maybe 12 GB, it would be so much better. RAM. A RAM is the memory or information storage in a computer that is used to store running programs and data for their programs. What does that mean? I mean, Steven, please explain to me what all these words mean. So I have a backpack right here. Oh my gosh, it's a kind of dirty camera bag. And let's try and see what things can fit into my camera bag. I'm packing my phone right here, 5 meter or 16 foot pluxometer. So everything that I have here is something that I can reach at any moment. So if I want maybe the pen, if I want maybe my cell phone, I can always reach for it and grab it and I won't have any problem. But what happens if I want to put my jacket in here? What if I want to put this hoodie in there? Well, obviously it's not going to fit because there isn't any space. And if I try to make it fit, then everyone else over there will be very, very uncomfortable. So on your computer, there is a certain amount of programs that you can have open at the same time. So for example, you can have Photoshop and AutoCAD open at the same time. But if you open Google Chrome, if you open Lumion, then your whole computer will crash. So maybe I'm running Photoshop and if I have a good RAM, I can also have AutoCAD open. And if I have a really good computer, I can also have Lumion and some Google Chrome tabs open. So your RAM is going to determine the capacity of this storage. Right now, you don't want a computer that has a RAM below 12 GB. I think that is the minimum that you can go. If you are in a really low budget, it can only get a computer that has 8 GB of RAM. I would recommend getting a computer that has another memory slot. So for example, you can put later when you have more money, another 8 GB of RAM and then end up with 16 GB of memory. Again, the higher the number, the better, the more RAM you have, the better. I think right now I have 32 GB of RAM and everything runs pretty quickly. I can have Spotify, Photoshop, Premiere Pro open. I can also have Lumion, AutoCAD, everything open. So right now it works pretty good, but I'm also looking in the future to upgrade my RAM because, you know, bigger is always better. And of course, with a good RAM, you will be able to have Illustrator and Photoshop open at the same time. Now, if you want to learn much more on Illustrator, I recommend you go to Skillshare, which is the sponsor of today's video. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. Explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity. You can learn literally anything in Skillshare, from illustration, graphic design, animation, all over to productivity hacks and photography. It's curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they're always launching new premium classes, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And it's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. So one class I fully recommend if you want to learn Illustrator is Mastering Illustrator 10 Tips and Tricks to Speed Up Your Workflow by DKNG Studios, which they are a graphic design agency. And in just 40 minutes with, you know, a few 12 lessons, they teach you how to master the basics of Illustrator so you can start applying it for your architecture illustrations. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get 30% off an annual premium membership so you can explore your creativity. So even if you've already had a free trial of Skillshare, you can still take advantage of this offer to get a full year of unlimited learning and creative exploration. Now let's talk about hard drives and data storage options. Now there are two that you should know, which is the hard disk drive and another one is the solid state drive. Now the best one between these two is a solid state drive because it just opens your programs much quicker. It opens your computer much quicker. Like everything is so much quicker, but it is also much more expensive. So I would recommend to balance out the two. So if you have your programs installed in your solid state drive, then you may want a solid state drive of maybe at a minimum of 500 gigabytes. And then you would also want a separate storage option, like for a hard drive, of 1 terabyte or 2 terabytes. Right now I have one solid state drive of 500 gigabytes, I think. And I think I have 3 separate external hard drive disks where I store different things of Show It Better, of my personal projects, and of things that I've saved up in the past. But a solid state drive is recommended, super recommended, to have all of your programs installed, because everything will just run so smoothly and so quickly. And seriously, you will be amazed. And finally, let's talk about screen size. Now, obviously, if you're buying a laptop, you don't want a big computer screen size, because this will take a charge on your back, on your whole body, because obviously it's going to be much, much heavier. But you also don't want to strain your eyes as much, because if you have a very small screen, like maybe a MacBook 13 inch or 11 inch, then you will not see all the details, all the things you're actually creating in Photoshop, SketchUp, or Revit. So try to balance out these two. I would really recommend having minimum a 15 inch laptop, but if you're using an external monitor at home, then try buying from a 24 inch to a 27 inch, because that will just really bring out the detail. You can see what you're actually working on. And of course, have a screen size that has a nice resolution of minimum Full HD, like 1920 by 1080. If you can go 4K, it will be good. But if you go 4K, maybe on Lumion, maybe on some architecture programs, everything will take a little bit longer in processing. So take that into account as well. So do you have your list ready? Are you ready to go? Are you ready to go and buy your computer? Now let's recap on these key points. For the processor, I would recommend a minimum of an Intel Core i5 of 9th generation, or the AMD equivalent of that, and a recommended of Intel Core i7th of 9th generation, or the AMD equivalent of that as well. For a graphics card, higher is always better. So I would recommend to go for a GeForce 1650 at the most minimum, but a recommended one would be an RTX 3080 or higher, and minimum 8 gigs of memory. For RAM, minimum go to 12 gigs of RAM, but if you can do 16 and get a computer that has slots for future upgrades, then that will be very, very cool. For hard drives, I recommend to get an SSD to have your programs installed, and an HDD for storage of all files. And finally, for the screen size, the bigger the better, but take into account your back pain. Don't go too heavy. Also your eyesight, don't go too small. So that's it. That's like the guide that you need to go and buy your computer. Now, obviously we can create a video suggesting very specific laptops, but if you're watching this maybe, I don't know, in 2025 and 2030, I don't know, whatever year you're coming from, then probably these laptops can be a little bit outdated and won't have the specs recommended. So if you're watching this maybe a year later after this video was released, then try to upgrade by a number on each of the categories, maybe from 12 gigs to, I don't know, 16 gigs or 15 gigs, etc. Also, if you are interested in my specific setup, I will leave all the links in the description to everything that I have. So I currently don't have a laptop, which I could recommend to you, but I do have a computer, like a setup computer, that I have is different personalization, different things, which I think you guys can like. So I'm really intrigued in what is your budget for your computer right now if you want to upgrade. And if you don't want to upgrade, I want to know what computer you have right now. What specs do you have, or what specs do you recommend? Do you guys recommend a MacBook? Do you recommend a PC? Or do you recommend AMD versus Intel? Let me know in the comments. I would love to read you. And if you want to see my desk setup, comment down below as well, so I can make a video on that as well. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in a next video. Bye. So let me just tell you about my personal experience with laptops, with my architecture student laptop career, I guess. The first laptop I had, I think, was an Asus back in 2010. Obviously, I didn't have enough money, so it was a very limited Asus. And also, I didn't have enough money to buy a new one when I was in third year or fourth year. So I had it more or less for 4 years of my student career. After that, obviously, it just burned out. It didn't take it anymore because I was trying to do everything at the same time, you know, videos, Photoshop, Revit, V-Ray, etc. So it just burned out. After that, I had an Acer laptop, which was really, really good. I think it's one of those gamers with those Acer gamer laptops, which were really good, but they just heated up so fast, so much, and I couldn't have any programs open yet. And it was a time where I was able to kind of like set up my own computer, buy my own computer, and I was deciding between if I wanted to buy another laptop and just wait for it to die out eventually, maybe over the years, or have my own setup where I could just keep on upgrading it and never kind of like run out of it. So that's what I did. I went to a place that set up my personal computer. I, you know, took all these requirements, just like I'm telling you guys to, you know, take into account the SSD card or the SSD or the memory card or whatever. And I took it over to like the technician, the person that was going to do me the favor of trying to like set up my computer and or like build my computer, and he or they built me up a really good computer, which has these specs right here that you guys can see right here. And I've had it for over 2 years now, and it's been working really, really good. I don't regret it at all. I would maybe want to upgrade the processor or maybe the graphics card, something like that, but it's just, you know, something for me, but it's not, that's not such a big deal. I have many programs open, and I think it can support them very good. Very recently, I bought a second monitor, which is something that is very essential to your workspace because it really does change the game. Obviously, we don't have much money all the time. We're always on a budget. So I try to save up maybe, I don't know, $2,000, for example. And I think with that, you can get a good computer. With $2,000, you can get a very decent computer in any part of the world. If you want to go higher, then obviously go higher. But with $2,000, you will get a computer that can maybe last you for 5 to 6 or 7 years. What do you guys think?